Hey, this is Peter from NextEnd, and today I'll show you how to build one of our latest slider templates, the photo story. Let's get started. First, I'll just go ahead and create a new project. The default project and slider type is fine, so I'll move on and name the slider, then set its dimensions. I want it to be full width, which is already selected, so I'll click on Create. Let's head over to the Controls tab and disable the arrows, because I will create a custom navigation with layers. Next, let's move on to the Animations tab to change the horizontal effect to a simple fade. That's all, so I'll save the slider. Now let's add an image slide. Although I could add more slides at once, I'll only select the first image now. I'll go to the slide editor. The first thing we need to do here is adding a gradient overlay because I would like better readability on my slide. I'll pick the direction, set the color, and enable the overlay setting. I want to put my layers on the bottom, so I will change the vertical align at the content layer. Everything is great, so let's start adding layers. First, I need a new row, then a heading layer. I can configure the content the layer displays and how it looks at the layer window. By clicking on the More button, I can adjust some advanced settings. I need a layer that has very similar settings, so I'll duplicate the one I've just made. Then I will drag it to the other column. I'll adjust some styling options and change the text. My layout needs another column, so I'll duplicate the last one. Now I will just need to replace the text inside the heading layer. To bring the layer closer together, I have to disable the full width option at the row and reduce the gutter to 5 pixels. I don't want the default paddings either, so I'll remove them. When that's done, I will remove the padding from the columns as well. I could adjust paddings on the UI, but I'll do it in the layer window this time. Let's create a large heading now. Let's just type in the text. Adjust the font color, size, letter spacing, and you're done. I will make some space below the heading, so I will set the bottom margin. Let's move on to the bottom section and add the new row. We want to have an arrow and the text next to each other, so put another row inside the first column. Let's place an image layer in the left column. The right column needs another heading layer, where I need to adjust the styling. After everything is set, I'll select the row that contains these layers. Let's turn off the full width option, reduce the gutter, and remove the paddings. Let's remove the padding from each column. Then duplicate the row. I'll move it to the empty column, then duplicate this outer column. Now I will replace the images and the texts. The columns in the right-hand row are in the wrong order, so I'll change them. Now let's make the row switch slides. Let's click on the plus icon at the link, then go to the Action tab and select the next slide action. Let's pick the row on the left and select the previous slide action at the link. To add the final touch, let's select the outer left column and change the inner align to left. Then I'll select the outer right column and change its inner align to right. There are many layers which have unnecessary paddings, so let's remove them. Don't forget to hold the Shift button to speed up your workflow. Let's select the content layer and remove its paddings too. Finally, I'll increase the bottom padding of the slide. It's time to add the text animation. This special effect is available on the heading layers, so let's select it at the big headline. The text animation needs to move less, so I'll change the offset Y value. Let's add the slide rotation as well. Let's click on Apply to add the animation to the layer. The easiest way to manage the animations is to open the timeline. Before moving on, I want to play the animation I added. It looks great, so I'll start adding layer animations. I will select the first column of the first row. I'll pick the bottom fade animation to start, but I'll change the offset Y value here as well. It looks great, so I will copy this animation and paste it on the other columns of this row. I'll drag the animations to create some delay. Let's check how the slide looks now. It's great, so it's time to adjust the slider for smaller screens. At the device selector, I will pick the tablet view first. It looks as if I need to make changes here, so I select the big headline. By using the font resizer, I will make the text smaller, so it would fit in one line. Everything else is fine, so move on to the mobile view. Okay, this view doesn't look good. I will start with reducing the text size of the big headline. If you double-click on the number, you can write in custom sizes. The columns at the first row are below each other. Let's put them in one line by setting the wrap after to 0 on the row. Then I will adjust the text size from the layer window. The last row also needs its columns next to one another. So I will change the gutter and the wrap after to 0. Then I will hide the column where the next slide's title is. It's time to adjust the content in the middle column. I will select the row inside and change the wrap after to make the columns appear next to one another. The other columns are too wide, so I will give them a maximum width. Now the middle columns have enough space. As a final touch, I will change some spacing. First, I will adjust the margin of the headline. Then I will select the slide using its label, and set top padding to make it taller. And then I'll reduce its bottom padding. As you can see, the desktop view hasn't changed. Let's see how it looks in the preview. My slide is ready, so I'll save it. My second slide has the same layout as the first one, so I will duplicate this slide. You can double-click on the slide name here and type in a new name for the slide. Click on the new slide to go to the slide editor. As you can see, it looks exactly like the slide we have made. Now you just need to select a different image and change the text. You can duplicate your slide to create the third slide quickly. After that, your slider will be ready for publishing. I hope this tutorial helped you learn more about Smart Slider. If you want to see similar videos in the future, make sure to subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video.